A couple days ago, we put up a video about the worst Bethesda fails of all time, and I thought it was warranted that we go to the other side of the spectrum. Bethesda is one of the biggest game publishers in the world. They love to pride themselves on a very high quality, a very high level of quality assurance. While they may not always hit that mark, there's no denying they have put out some incredible games over the years. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Today, we're going to be looking at some of those games. We're going to look at some Bethesda games that were awesome. Now, all a game has to do to be eligible for this list is either be developed or published by Bethesda. If their name is on it, it is eligible. And if that sounds fair to you guys, let me know in the comment section, what is your favorite Bethesda game of all time? And here we go. Dishonored. Now, we're going to kick off the list with an awesome first-person stealth game developed by Arkane Studios and published by none other than Bethesda in 2012. You played as a bodyguard for an empress who is framed for her murder, and then it's up to you to try to uncover who really did it so you can bring them to justice and clear your name. The game has a very, very choice-driven style to it. Every level allows you to go either in for kills or to play it completely peaceful without killing a single person. It is a true stealth game, which we don't get a lot these days, and it did a great job of calling back to classic stealth games like Thief. Plus, the amount of options you have during the gameplay allows for a ton of replayability, as you can experiment with going completely bloodbath playthroughs or totally pacifist playthroughs. You literally don't have to kill one person in this game to beat it. The Elder Scrolls Online. MMORPGs are a pretty big part of the gaming industry. Everybody will agree with that. But creating a new one in this day and age, that's not easy. But Bethesda did not let that stop them when they created the Elder Scrolls Online, which is an MMORPG tied into the Elder Scrolls series that helped flesh out the lore as well as give fans a new way to experience that style of RPG gameplay, but now with friends. Elder Scrolls Online launched in April of 2014 to decent reception, but thanks to various updates and expansions, and they kept working on it, it has grown to be one of the biggest MMOs in the world. Recent reports actually state that ESO now has over 10 million registered users and about 2.5 million active users. It's one of the closest things to compete with World of Warcraft. Quake Live. This one is kind of cheating because it's basically just an updated version of an existing game, but I'm still going to put it on here thanks to many people considering it to be the best multiplayer game in the series, and it simply wouldn't have existed if it weren't for Bethesda. Released in August of 2010, Quake Live is an updated re-release of Quake 3 Arena featuring improved servers, more features, and overall a better modern multiplayer feel to it. Now, Quake didn't really have a great single-player offering like other games in the series, but it is still considered by many fans to be the definitive Quake multiplayer experience, and it had a pretty big competitive scene that is still going to this day. It's one of those franchises that kind of died out after its gameplay style fell out of mainstream fashion, but thanks to the success of Doom and Wolfenstein reboots, I think there may be a chance that more old-school style FPS games, especially arena shooters, could be making a comeback, and I'm hoping that sometime soon we get a new Quake game that kind of harkens back to the series' roots. I know we have Quake Champions right now, but that game is a little too different for a lot of people's liking. Morrowind. Now, this was the third Elder Scrolls game, and it made quite a few changes to the series that some of them were controversial at the time, but looking back now, it was the beginning of something good. Morrowind not only shifted the gameplay to a more realistic and HD experience, but it also shifted the storytelling from a more focused style to something more open-ended that gave the player more control over how they experience the world. Now, many people criticized this decision since it put less focus on the main story of the game, but it planted the seed for the style of more open-ended RPG gameplay that Bethesda is now known for. Morrowind was a huge success. It sold over 4 million copies in its first 3 years on the market, but the reason why it's down at number 7 is because looking back now, there were a good amount of issues with it. Now, this is to be expected since the game was breaking new ground with its design and its issues, and these issues would later be resolved with the next Elder Scrolls game, but Morrowind is still an extremely well-made game, and it deserves to be on this list. Fallout 3. Now, following Bethesda's acquisition of the Fallout license, the first thing they did with it was transition the 2D isometric RPG series into a 3D first-person RPG more like the Elder Scrolls games. Fallout 3 was released in 2008 to great reception from fans and critics thanks to its solid storytelling, its intriguing world, its fun gameplay, and the fact that it was basically Elder Scrolls but with guns. Fallout 3 was the game that moved the franchise into the structure that we know and love today, and going back and playing it today, it still holds up pretty well in terms of world building and game design. Sure, there's plenty of technical issues, but that's kind of to be expected from a game this massive. And if you play the game on PC right now, it's easy to fix those issues with mods and the setting changes. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. Wolfenstein: The New Order. Now, Wolfenstein is one of those franchises that first popularized first-person shooters, mainly thanks to Wolfenstein 3D back in 1992. However, following the success of the classics, the series kind of floundered, never really maintaining any consistency as the games were either really good or really bad. In 2014, Bethesda teamed up with developer Machine Games to create Wolfenstein: The New Order, which was a full reboot of the entire series that featured faithful updates of the classic gameplay with a few modern twists like weapon upgrades and stealth mechanics to keep things fresh. That's the way to do it. The New Order also had a surprisingly great story to go along with it, telling a very interesting character-driven story about a resistance that was desperately trying to fight back against the regime in an alternate history where Germany won the Second World War and they conquered the entire world. Thanks to the excellent storytelling, the gameplay, the level design, everything, it all encouraged exploration and experimentation as opposed to just linear shooting like modern shooters. Wolfenstein: The New Order gets the number 5 spot. Skyrim. Now, it might bug some people with this one being down at number 4, but hear me out on it, okay? It was the 5th main entry in the Elder Scrolls series. It was released in late 2011 to critical acclaim thanks to its amazing world and map design. It had really good character building and addictive gameplay that many people are still playing. Skyrim also got a ton of mileage from its modding community that made some pretty awesome things out of the base game, and they continue to create new things out of the tools that Skyrim set forward for them. As of the recording of this video, Skyrim has been ported to every platform and sold over 30 million copies, making it one of the best-selling single-player games of all time. There's no multiplayer. Skyrim is definitely one of the most successful and legendary games Bethesda has ever released, but the reason it's at number 4 is because in terms of new ideas and mechanics, there wasn't a whole lot when compared to Oblivion. When looking at Skyrim objectively, it's kind of just an updated version of Oblivion. Now, that's not a bad thing, and Skyrim is more than deserving of a spot on today's list, but I wanted to explain to some of you Skyrim enthusiasts why it wasn't at number 1. Fallout New Vegas. Bethesda acquired the Fallout IP in the mid-2000s, and ever since then, it's been one of their, if not their main franchises. But with that being said, it's kind of ironic that the best Fallout game, it wasn't made by them. Fallout New Vegas was released in 2010, and it was developed by Obsidian Entertainment as a spinoff to Fallout 3. Despite being rushed through development, being forced to kind of reuse a lot of assets from Fallout 3, New Vegas has gone down in gaming history as the definitive Fallout experience thanks to Obsidian taking the framework of Fallout 3 and doing so much more with it. Plus, like most other Bethesda RPGs, the mod-out community for New Vegas is huge, creating tons of awesome stuff out of the game to make it even better and create even more possible experiences. To many people, New Vegas is the ultimate Fallout experience, and to me, it's deserving of the number 3 spot today. Doom 2016, the reboot. I've played this entire game. It's amazing. I can't wait for Doom Eternal. It's one of those franchises that had an amazing start and helped influence the industry as a whole in many, many ways. But it kind of struggled to remain relevant once the 2000s started. Due to the rise of games like Call of Duty and Halo, more old school shooters like Doom, they fell out of style. And the series basically resigned to just re-releasing the old games. But ID Software and Bethesda shocked everybody in 2016 with a full, faithful reboot of the classic FPS in the form of Doom 2016, one of the best reviewed games of that year and considered by many to be one of the best FPS games ever made. It played like a faithful modern reimagining of the original Doom games, keeping the open-ended level design, super fast-paced combat, and the over-the-top violence, and even some light RPG elements for character and weapon upgrades. It was a huge success, to say the least, and it not only brought the franchise into the modern era, but it also proved definitively there is indeed a place for single-player FPS games in the modern market, and everybody is waiting for Doom Eternal. Oblivion takes the number 1 spot. Now, Oblivion was not the first traditional Bethesda RPG. It was arguably, though, the game that really kickstarted Bethesda's RPGs as we know them and began the golden age of first-person RPGs in gaming. It was the 4th game in the Elder Scrolls series, and it was a follow-up to Morrowind, a very, very innovative and great game on its own, we already talked about, but it improved on everything. It maintained that more open-ended style of gameplay and storytelling introduced in Morrowind, while refining both the main story gameplay and the side quests, kind of making the world feel more immersive and the story feel more personal to you, the player. The map itself was greatly improved thanks to better visuals and better map and quest design, and it also made use of the Radiant AI system, which allowed the NPCs to actually make choices and interact with the world in more ways than before. Oblivion was the first game in the series to have voice acting for every character. It was a massive success. I mean, it innovated, it had quality, and it's considered by many to be one of the best games ever made. So thanks to the innovation in the RPG genre and in Bethesda's game design philosophy, as well as the incredible quality of the game itself, I believe Oblivion deserves the title of the best Bethesda game of all time. You guys, let me know where you agree. Let me know where you disagree. If you guys enjoyed the video, take a second, make sure you're subscribed, turn on those post notifications, and I'll see you soon.